As usual, I know y'all say every guest is amazing. Hey, we can't help but charge it to the game. We have amazing guests.
Yes.
And so now we have another amazing guest, and she's done some amazing things. So I'm going to let Wifey introduce her to
yes,
the platform.
Yes, yes, yes. I'm super excited. We were just chatting with her during the commercial break. We have the lovely, amazingly talented, who can sing the roof off as well as act anything, Chandra Curley. Y'all,
yep, yep.
Please,
let's give it up.
Woo!
Welcome to Spotlight. Can she hear us?
Can you hear us now?
Vaguely.
Okay.
We're working on it.
We're going to try to make that better. Welcome to Spotlight over the city. How are you?
I'm good. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thanks for having me.
We are so excited. You look amazing.
Thank you. Quarantine look, huh?
Listen, how have you been holding up during this?
Well, that's one thing about the Zoom. I mean, when you get a chance to do the Zoom, because we're not really going out. So, and I take that opportunity to kind of, you know, dress up, because you don't usually get a chance to do that much, you know, by the venues and everything being closed.
Yes, well, you did an amazing job, because you look really, really good, girl. So, yes.
Thank you.
Look like you we going out to one of your stage plays. So listen,
yeah, I had to look good for you.
That's right. Well, you did a good job. Tell us about what's been going on with you during the quarantine. How have things been going for you?
Well, actually, it's going really great, because I was fortunate enough to do a show on BET Plus called Bruh, and so, you know, when everything else shut down, my new show, Bruh, was coming out on BET Plus.
That's
so
right.
That was, you know, that was nothing but God right there, that kind of put me in a position where I was able to still be, you know, visible to my fan base, you know, and still be relevant and have a new show out even during the, you know, pandemic.
And so that's perfect, because we're all at home and we ain't got nothing else to do but watch Bruh and catch up on all the other old stuff that you've been doing. So it worked out.
That's right. God is good. Look at it.
Yeah, because BET now, of course, you know, they're showing a lot of the plays. And so I thought everybody had, you know, seen the plays, but obviously it's a big number of people and another generation who've never seen these plays or heard about them, or were at a certain age where they really couldn't appreciate it, but their moms were playing them all the time. Now they're getting a chance to look at them. So, yeah, that's a good thing, too. So timing is great.
Timing is great. Well, I want you to know that I personally am loving the comedy in this series, Bruh. And I have not seen you put your work into anything that hasn't been great. And that's just being real.
Well, the thing about Bruh is, you know, I love the fact that I'm working with young actors. They kind of give you another kind of enthusiasm as I reinvent myself over and over again. And, you know, connecting yourself with millennials, it's kind of giving me a rebirth. And
yeah.
So I feel really fortunate to be able to not only bring my wisdom, but they bring me something new.
Yeah, see, so you all bounce off of each other. I love it.
Yes.
I love it. So so recording that series, are you all done? Like, what's next for Bruh? Like, are you all still recording? Like, what's going on?
Well, you know, where we, this was like the first half of the series, of the first season. And so the second second half starts in September.
Wonderful.
You know, so you'll see the second half, which is great. I mean, it gets like deeper and deeper.
I know. I was about to say, like, can you tell us it's about to get deeper and deeper? You can't tell too much, I know. But at least we know that we get more coming back in September.
Because, you know, I always say, you know, Tyler's really messy. And so he will go places, you know, we know about him, but nobody tells it.
Yeah.
But he's the person to tell it. And say, oh, no, people really do this, you know.
Absolutely.
So, I'm excited for people to see the second half of the first season.
Now, does Tyler Perry get involved a lot with you all with this project? Like, how closely is he involved with Bruh?
Oh, he's hands on.
Yeah.
Of course, he wrote all the scripts himself, and he directed all the episodes.
Wonderful. Wow. How about that?
Yeah, that's wonderful.
Yes.
Such a blessing, though, to get to work with the great. Like, that's one of the people that I admire. He is a great in our midst.
Yeah.
He has changed the game for all of us, right? And so I'm proud of him.
So.
I'm very proud of him.
I think the reason why, you know, because a lot of people think, well, he just wants to do everything. But I think early on he learned that he had to trust, visionary, to put your vision in the hands of other people can be complicated. And so I don't think he really trusts people to handle the people that sees his work.
Yeah.
You know, he knows what the people want to hear. He knows what they want to see. And so he take it upon himself to not let that get confused or complicated to the fact that it doesn't look like his stuff anymore. So I think that's why he's kind of hands-on.
Yeah, I think that's smart.
I do, too. I think that is smart. You have so many different accolades under your belt, Chandra. I bet Stan doesn't know this part. You have some songs with the SOS band being the lead singer. Ha, ha, ha. Is that right?
That's right.
Okay. Well, give us one sample of one of her songs right now.
Oh, he just put me on the spot.
Since you
want
to play games,
you got to help me.
Then tell me one of the songs that she has with SOS.
Well, I can tell you an SOS band song, and we can do it. Take your time. Do it right.
Okay. Now, Sean, I don't know what she's trying to play, but I got her. I got her.
Yeah, she did that very well. I thought she did that very well.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Yes, but yes, she does have, she's got this singing ability that puts chills and goosebumps on you. And you were here in D.C., Chandra, you were in the Lolita Snipes production play. Do you remember that?
Head Over Heels.
Do you remember?
Yep,
and we were there. It was Q Parker and the young lady that was on our show. She was on our show. Her name is Shantario. She was on this show about 2 months ago. Do you remember her?
Yeah. Yes. Very talented.
Yes.
She is so talented. I sent her a message the other day because I don't know what she was doing. She was like skating and singing. And I was like, well, is it anything you can't do?
Well, that's how we feel about you. Is there anything you can't do? That's how we feel about you.
Well, you know, it's all by the grace of God, you know, and, you know, your gift will make room.
Yeah.
And so, yeah. And so I do not take the gifts for granted. I know that I'm truly blessed to be able to do it. And also, it's more so than my gift is the mentality. And I have a great work ethic.
Yes.
I think that the bottom line is, are you willing to work for it? And so that's really what it's about.
Yeah, but I love what you say when you give honor to God. And so kudos to you for that, because a lot of people don't realize where their blessings come from. And so I do realize that you are not that person. So I thank you for just being humble enough to say, giving God the credit for putting you in positions.
Yes.
Yeah,
yes,
that's a big deal.
I give him the glory.
Yeah.
Yeah. So many times, especially in this business, you have to have a strong foundation because it's about illusion. And it's very important for you to know what's real.
Yeah.
Yes,
for you
definitely.
To the point of what's real in you. Because people will convince you that you're something else. You got to know the difference. You got to know, I am not my gifts. You know,
I love that.
I'm not my gifts.
I love that.
That is a beautiful. That's a tweet. That's a tweet. That's a T-shirt. Yes. I am not my gift. So that was humbling. That'll keep you humble.
That'll keep you humble.
That's humbling.
We got one of our audience members just sent a question in and said to ask you, did you sing the lead on Weekend Girl? I'm your weekend girl.
Well, no, that well, actually, that's Mary Davis and Abdul Raul.
Oh, okay. Yeah, one of our viewers sent that in question, and we wanted to get that question out. But you did know that song, though, didn't you? She knew what I was talking about.
Very much so.
Yeah, I had to sing that song, yeah.
If you had to choose, and we're not going to make you choose, and you could only sing for the rest of your life or act, what are you going to choose?
I did not hear you.
If you had to choose, and we're not going to make you choose, but if you had to pick just singing for the rest of your life or acting, which one are you going to pick?
That's not really a hard answer because it's really all about storytelling. And I say I'm a storyteller. So happen I have two different mediums that I can work through. I can work through singing or I can work through acting.
Yeah.
But basically, I'm a storyteller.
You tell the stories. Yes, indeed. I love it. Do you have a favorite project that you've worked on from your acting side of your lifestyle? Do you have one that's been your favorite? Because you've been on A Diary of a Mad Black Woman. I mean, you've got some stuff under your belt. Do you have a favorite?
That's kind of hard because, like, again, like you said, you know, I do so many genres and so many different things because they all have a different kind of meaning. Because it could be like a stage play or what is my favorite film piece or what's my favorite concert or something that I recorded. I can't really have a favorite.
Yeah, I guess that's a safe answer. That's a safe answer because you're in so many different areas. And like you say, you tell stories in each one of those buckets.
Yeah. So you would have to go like, you know, what's your favorite film? What's your favorite play? What's your favorite?
Right. So you got a lot going on. You
know, on each one.
Yeah. So it can't be like, it can't be, you know, the real general for me. But I love the fact that that I do have longevity.
Yes, indeed.
And I have miles and miles, a body of work.
Yes, you
that
do.
I'm proud of. I think I'm proud of that, just the body of work and still being here.
And still being relevant. You are super relevant.
So for the younger people that's coming into the industry, what would you give them as a piece of advice to show them how to have longevity? Like, it should be some type of key or clues to it because everybody doesn't have longevity in the industry. What would you say to them? How would you help them along the way to have longevity?
Great question.
Wow. You know, how you have longevity is, that's what learning the craft is all about. See, the craft is the thing that gives you the stamina. It gives you the longevity. Because once you learn the craft, you're not trendy. So when the trend stops, you can still survive. You know, if they're looking for people who look a certain kind of way, you know, or even in music, that everybody sound the same. I'm gonna sound like that. But once that sound is gone, then what do you do? So you basically have to learn how to sing and hear your voice. So it doesn't matter about the trend, you know. So learning the craft is so important. That's the thing that teaches you how to work with everybody, you know. You know, everybody has a standard, just like how you work. It's certain things that you do that everybody does, that you got to do it that way in order to put on a production like this. It's like somebody coming in and just like, I want to be on television, but then you don't know the basics. You don't know the technical side. Yeah. You just know I can just point a camera or I can get in front of a camera. But that's not the thing that gets it, you know? So it's important to learn that craft. I know we can make it seem like it's easy, that it looks like we just jumped up, you know? I was funny at the family reunion. Well, okay. Well, you need to stay at the family reunion to be funny. But it's like, you know, they love you. But then you're dealing with people that don't know you like that. And so you know, and I know it looks like that for Tyler too. Like he just up and he was just self-taught. But Tyler studied. Everybody had their own way of doing it. Not everybody had to go to school for years or 2 or 3 years or something like that. But get under somebody's wing that knows.
Okay.
Because everybody learns differently, you know, and he's like a sponge. So he can just look at it because he's a genius and look at it and break it down. Everybody they doesn't have that kind of ability. But some people can watch something and figure it out and talk to somebody. But yeah. Always have an example, you know, to look at. Even if you didn't take classes, I mean, you know, they're doing like a lot of Zoom things now because a lot of the actors and musicians and technicians, they're not working. But they can, you know, give out their knowledge. And this is a good time to kind of get that stuff in. And once, you know, everything opened up, you know, you walking out the house different than when you came in.
I know that's right.
I think that is amazing advice. I would advise everyone at the sound of my voice that is interested in entertainment or any field that's going to grow you to take that advice. Very sound advice. Very sound advice.
Well, you're not getting out much, Chandra, but if you want to just share, you know, something fun that you've done throughout this quarantine, something, a fun fact about you that maybe some of your fans don't know.
Well, I've been doing Zumba classes. I've been shaking it up, girl.
I know, that's right.
That's right. Get it right.
Get it right.
Trying to stay active and fit, you know.
Yeah.
Because also, you know, during this time, you know, you can get a little depressed. And, you know, because you're not moving, you know, you're not being active, and you're eating everything you shouldn't be eating. But I've been doing, like, maybe 4 days a week, and then I go walking, but just trying to stay physically fit.
Active, yeah.
It's just very important to me. So that's what I've been doing. I've been doing Zumba classes, and they're great. Like, I have a Zoom gospel class. I mean, wow, it's fun. And I've gotten so now that if I don't do it, I mean, I miss it. I mean, it's just my body's longing to don't, you know, we should be doing this, you know.
I know, that's right. I love it.
I'm gonna put the clip. I'm gonna post a clip. That's what I'm gonna do.
I want to see. Let me try.
That's right. Maybe you're gonna inspire my wife. She's gonna start doing Zumba.
Yes. Oh, yes. Well, it was so, 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 so good catching up with you. I want you to know that Spotlight Over the City is here to stay. And if our platform can ever be of use for you, we are considering you family to the show.
Yes.
Thank you for offering that.
Yes.
And thank you for your amazing energy.
Yes.
You have amazing energy.
Yes.
I love it.
Yes. Thank you. We appreciate it.
And bless you on the show. And I'm praying that everything goes great and that things are bigger and better for you.
Thank you. God is amazing. He's blessing all of us.
And we are all going to be watching Bruh. That's right.
Make sure you guys lock and load the Bruh.
BET Plus.
That's right.
BET Plus. What days again? What's the days? What's the days and times?
What's that?
The days and times.
The days and times that Bruh come on.
Well, you know, it's streaming.
Yes, BET Her. They can watch it whenever they want.
Okay, cool. So, okay, BET Plus. All right, thank you for being a part of the family, and we'll see you soon.
Thank you. God bless you.
That's right. Let's give it up one more time.
Woo! Yeah!
Man, another amazing guest.
She's great. Amazing.
I love her energy.
I love her energy.
Yes.
And she can sing, too. I wish she would have been able to sing.
I should have asked her.
You can't get what you don't ask for, right? I should have said, drop a line.
Yeah, you should have. And then